Jason was sitting at a local bar one night in October, and he was talking to his friend Michael about making a very scary scarecrow that would frighten anyone away. He told his friend, "I am going to make the most frightening scarecrow. Believe me, it is going to be the most realistic scarecrow you will be able to see, and all these pesky high school kids who come around my way drinking, well, they will get such a fright and so bad that they will never come back again to drink or do whatever it is they do around my way. Just you wait and see, I'm going to have it ready for Halloween." His friend looked at him strangely and said, "How are you going to make a scarecrow to frighten teenagers? I mean, they hardly scare little kids." Jason gave a sinister smile and said, "Just you wait and see." That night, Jason went into the barn and got as much straw that he needed to make the scarecrow. 2 days later, his friend Michael was trying to call Jason, but there was no answer. He kept calling his phone, but he kept getting onto the answer machine. After eventually giving up, he walked over to Jason's house and knocked on the door, but there was no answer. He looked into the field and saw a scarecrow, no doubt the one Jason was telling him about. Michael walked up to the scarecrow and looked at it to see what all the fuss was about and what made it so scary. As he looked at it, something seemed familiar, but he didn't know what. He walked back to his house. 3 days passed and Jason hadn't heard from Michael. Something told him to go to his house to check, and when he did once again, there was no answer. He heard some shouting up towards the scarecrow. He ran up to see what it was, and he screamed with fright when he saw 4 teenagers lying down next to it covered in blood after being stabbed numerous times with a fork. He heard some movement and looked around. Then he froze in fear, realizing no one was there except the scarecrow. He looked up at it and he saw its eyes moving. He now knew what seemed familiar. It was Jason's eyes. He realized that the scarecrow was actually Jason. Then the scarecrow gave a sinister smile, which was Jason's sinister smile. It was Jason under the scarecrow. And he smiled and gave a weird laugh. Michael screamed, and with that, 2 police officers held their guns up to him. "Freeze, you're under arrest." When he tried to explain to the police the scarecrow was Jason, they looked at him like he was crazy, and he was eventually arrested for the murder of the teenage boys that he didn't commit. Jason's body was found inside the scarecrow, and the community and everyone put it down to suicide. But no one knew the truth. Jason sacrificed himself to become the most frightening scarecrow only when it suited him, which was the reason he didn't frighten Michael. One night Michael was in his prison cell. He had a dream where Jason told him he never intended him to get blamed for his crimes. When he woke up, he found straw in his bed.